huge news last week when Airtable, unexpectedly to most of us, announced new prices. Not only new prices, but we're talking brand new tiers that never even existed before. Some people are really upset about this. Some of us are really excited. What camp do you fall into? Well, if you want to learn more about Airtable's new prices, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Airtable's one of those favorite no-code tools of ours. And in this video, we're going to be breaking down Airtable's newest pricing announcements that occurred in late August. They are going into effect September 2023. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for my free Airtable crash course. This crash course is going to teach you all of the basic building blocks, all those key features of Airtable, so that you can start unlocking the most that the software has to offer for you. You can go ahead and grab that free training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I will be sure to include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We have got to look at the new announcement that came from Airtable in terms of pricing. We have now four different tiers. Now, some of these have been repurposed, renamed, reassigned. So we're going to have to also talk about what the tiers used to be as well. But as you see, we have the free tier. Airtable has always had a freemium version. So yes, you can get started for free, but at some point you're going to likely need to upgrade. Next tier up is the team tier. Team is now at $20 per month if billed annually. Next up, we have business tier. This is a brand new tier that did not exist before, coming in at $45 a month if billed annually, or $54 a month if you're paying month to month. And then lastly, they've slightly changed their enterprise model to say enterprise scale. So how has this changed from where things were? Well, before we had four tiers, but they were not team and business. The middle two tiers were Plus and Pro. Plus was a $10 a month plan. Pro was a $20 a month plan. So they've shifted those middle tiers. And now we have team. Our first paid plan is at $20 a month. And from there, we can upgrade to business, which is a little more than two times the cost. And at that point, we're getting even more functionality. So what does this all mean for all of us Airtable users? Well, there's some good and some bad. The good is, if you were on the Plus plan before, the $10 a month, you are now getting access to the team plan at your former price. So you are now getting basically more functionality and you're not being charged anything extra. Now, if you were not in that Plus plan before, that does not impact you. If you were previously on a Pro plan, that was the former $20 a month plan, you are now on the team plan, and of course, with no noticeable change to your actual bill. The good news, on the other hand, though, is that we get more functionality inside of this business plan. So let's go ahead and look at what is being offered and exactly what is shifted here. So in the team plan, we're getting 50,000 records per base. This is exactly the same amount that we used to get on the Pro plan, which was, again, the $20 a month plan. So really not much of a change here. But the business plan offers an optional upgrade to 125,000 records per base. That is a lot more records. And this is something we've been asking Airtable for a long time. More records, more functionality. And they're saying, yes, we're willing to give that to you. But hey, we're running a business, we're gonna have to charge you a little more for it. So personally, I'm a little excited about this element of the business plan because finally we have an option to pay a little bit more, but get more capacity from our databases in Airtable. Now next, let's look at automations. This is a bit of a downgrade for team because previously, if I recall, the Pro plan, the $20 a month plan, was giving us 50,000 automation runs. But now, as you see, that's been cut in half, 25,000 Airtable automations. But still, that's a lot of automation, folks. I don't really feel like a lot is being taken away from me here. If I'm on a team plan and I'm getting 25,000 automation runs every month for that plan, that's an awful lot of automating. And if I'm overcoming that, I can probably afford to upgrade. Now let's look at the business option though. 100,000 automation runs on the business tier, which is awesome. Now we have something again that's between what used to be Pro and Airtable's Enterprise. We needed something in the middle ground and now we have it. Not only are we getting more records per base, but we're also getting more automation runs. Now another place where I feel like a little was taken away from us on the team plan, well, remember again, what used to be the Pro plan at 20 a month, that used to come with about 20 gigs of attachment space, and that is now cut in half to 10 gigs of attachment space. So some people are complaining about this. I've heard some chatter that some people are not very excited about, but I want to just add a little bit of a pause here. If you're storing more than 10 gigabytes of stuff in your Airtable bases, there is always the option of connecting to Google Drive. You can easily build integrations with Google Drive and through those automations, create new folders and store your information there. And you can still make that data, all those files, easily accessible. You can get to them with just a few clicks from inside your Airtable interfaces. You can build buttons that take you right to the different files you want to look at. You just don't store the files directly in Airtable. This has been available for years and years. The automations are cheap and easy to put together. So when people complain about not having that much attachment space in their databases, I feel like it's really not that valid because, to be fair, yes, it is cool to have those attachments directly in Airtable. But if you're really leveraging Airtable that much for attachment storage, you probably shouldn't be. It's not meant for that as a tool. It's not supposed to be the place where you keep video files and things of that nature. So again, use something like a true storage, like Dropbox, Google Drive, and simply automate that passing of attachments from Airtable. Now, on the business plan side of things though, if you really like your attachment space in Airtable, you get up to 100 gigs on that business plan. So another reason to really consider upgrading. Now, there are some other advantages to the team/business plan. So let's scroll on down and take more of a look here in terms of the comparison between plans. The one I really want to highlight is when we get down to these checkboxes in terms of what does not come with the team plan. And we don't start to see that until we get down to here. Verified data. This is a new thing that Airtable's been hinting at for a while. So if we hover over this, we see that we are allowed to create data sets that are approved and managed by an admin and made accessible in an organization-wide library. That's pretty cool. Verified data, meaning that we have data that has been at an admin level approved for use throughout different functions of an organization. Obviously, this makes a lot more sense for a bigger organization, which is why we're going to find it on that business and enterprise scale plan. We also see two-way sync, automatically syncing data and edits back and forth between workflows. And two-way sync is no longer like the old synced tables that we had, but now with true two-way sync, we edit data in one place and it's reflected in the other. And we can edit it in the other place and it's reflected back in the other source as well. So bi-directional syncing, finally a thing available on the business plan. We also have our standard sync integrations, syncing data from external sources into an Airtable base. This is still available on the team plan, so really no change there. But we do see the premium sync integrations. This is Jira, Salesforce, Zendesk, Tableau Online. These were things that used to only sync with Enterprise, and now we can sync them on that business plan. Again, making upgrading to that higher tier that much more valuable. In addition to that, Airtable is starting to experiment with some add-ons. This is really cool as well. If you haven't already checked it out, Airtable's AI is currently in beta, and you can add this on for an additional fee to your different workspaces, starting at the team, including the business and enterprise scale workspaces. So a lot of advanced functionality here. And then we get down to admin controls, the ability for you to actually denote admin users within an organization. Again, typically a medium or larger size organization that's going to want to leverage those more powerful functions and features, making it a business tier plan. So, what is the big takeaway? Well, in the fact that Airtable has announced these new changes, obviously, I'm pretty excited about having the business tier option, especially for our larger clients who are going to get a lot of benefit from this. But there is something that everybody has to be aware about, and we're not going to find it until we scroll all the way down here and we check out API calls per month. because I know that there are many, many folks who have built fully functioning applications on Airtable. They have one user on a free plan, and then they've built on top of that a softer interface, thus allowing hundreds of people to access their web application that they built using Airtable and softer. Well, if we look at something like that, you were previously able to do that on a free Airtable plan, but Airtable has wisened up and you're no longer getting a free ride on that Airtable plan. And the way that they're going to police this is by monitoring your API calls per month. An API call is made anytime you are accessing data inside of your Airtable database. So if you're doing something like passing it through an automation in Make, or you're creating a document, or you are using a softer or a no-loco front end, some sort of front end portal, well, that is performing an API call. You're accessing the data that lives in Airtable, and you're no longer getting that for free. On the free plan, you can only get 1,000 of those API calls per month. So if you're running a web application on something like Softr and you've been on a free plan for Airtable, it's probably not going to be sufficient moving forward. Now, on the team plan, on the other hand, you're getting 100,000 API calls. That's an awful lot of API calls. And then if we look at the business plan, then you have unlimited API calls, so you'll never run out of capacity there. The big issue that I'm hearing complaints about right now is that we don't currently know how many API calls we're actually making on a workspace in a given month. Nobody really has that visibility as of August 2023. So this is one of those areas that Airtable is going to have to work very diligently on rolling out some sort of functionality so that we know where we're at in comparison to our plan. I'm sure a lot of folks would be willing and able to upgrade if they knew exactly how many API calls they were making and it produced some sort of meaningful economic sense inside of their applications. But until we have transparency of that data, it's kind of a shot in the dark. I don't know exactly how many API calls we're making as a company every month, so I'm really looking forward to seeing that transparency in terms of our updated billing plans once Airtable's rolled that out. Now, we've been told that these new changes are going into effect September 2023, so there's a lot for Airtable to do in the meantime. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything I missed that you found about these new updates to pricing, or if you have any questions. And in the meantime, keep on building.